Good evening, everybody. We're going to jump straight into it. This is a power test on the UV28. I've programmed various frequencies in on the 2 meter, the 70 centimeter, and the 1.25 meter band. So let's get it turned on and do this.
Welcome. Channel mode.
Okay. Yes, it's been a while. I do apologize. I have been playing with that printer, that new 3D printer of mine I've got. Okay, starting here at one, I've picked various frequencies between the bottom end and the top end as according to the manual of each range. So let's try this one, which is 136. As you can see, I'm not broadcasting anything, it's on a dummy load. So all you people out there saying, no, you can't broadcast on that, I'm not, I'm doing a test. So 136, here we go. Okay, that's kicking out 6.1 watts. So let's go to the next one.
19.
Oops.
1, 2.
Channel number 2 is 146. That's kicking out 10.1.
3.
Next one is 155. 9.4. Next one is 166, 9.6, 173.5, 9.5, okay, now into the 1.25 meters, oh no, I can't broadcast on that one, it won't let me. I don't think it's going to let me do one on this one either. Nope, so let's move to the next one.
8.
Okay, 220. 6.5.
9.
230. 6.8. Well, nearly 6.9.
10.
The 240. 6.8.
11.
250. 6.5.
12.
259, 5.6.
13.
Okay, we're into the 400 or the 70 centimeter, which is 8.7 or 8.7.
14.
420, 9.3.
15.
440, 8.7.
16.
The 460 is 8.2.
17.
480. Okay, 40 is the end.
18.
And yep. Okay, so we're back to the beginning again. Okay, so there's various frequencies. Now it's a very quick test today, but one thing I have found is this radio does not have airband. This does not have AM airband receiving. Anybody wanting this radio for that? Well, tough luck, it doesn't have it. So far, this radio has been okay. It's not one of my favourites. I mean, it's a better design than the UV-29, which I didn't particularly like. But, so there's a quick power test for the UV28. It was touted to me as a 10-watt radio, so it does seem to be doing that, or almost that. Well, it was doing that on some channels on VHF, on the 2-meter, and about 8 on the UHF, so that's not too bad. And 5 or 6 again, was it, on the 220 band. Anyway, it seems to be pretty quiet on the new radio front. I haven't seen much out there that I've really been interested in getting. If you guys do see one and you're not too sure about it, and you want me to have a look at it and maybe get it in first and have a quick look, just let me know. Let me know in the comments. Anyway, I hope you like this video. And I'll try keep some more coming. I think I'm going to do some more on manually programming these radios, because there do seem to be a few people out there which like to know how to do it via the keypad. Each to their own, I don't really get it, but I suppose it would be good skill to have to know how to program it from the radio itself. What happens if your computer blows up, or if you don't have one of these TID radio wireless programmers and you don't have any phone with you? Anyway, I think I'm going to do a couple of little episodes on programming the radios now. I'm probably going to do it on all of my radios. So there are Baofengs. I do have a different range of radios anyway. But the next one up, I believe, I will be doing that. I'll put it on the screen. It's really late here in Vancouver now. 7-3s, and I will see you all soon. Good night. Oh, please like and subscribe my videos. It really helps the channel, and it helps me get motivated into like getting more radios. Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much now. Take care. Bye.